Hello guys, and welcome back to TechWolf. In this video, we are going to continue on in our Cisco Packet Tracer course. In previous lessons, we learned what is Cisco Packet Tracer, we went over how to download and install Cisco Packet Tracer, and we went over user interface of Cisco Packet Tracer. And in this video, we are going to build the very basic network you can build. And we will be building peer-to-peer network using Cisco Packet Tracer. And peer-to-peer network is a basic connection where two devices like PCs can communicate directly with each other, and we will assign IP addresses and subnet masks, and we'll troubleshoot and we'll check that this connectivity works. This is the very basic thing what you can build by using Cisco Packet Tracer. Like I mentioned in my previous videos, this Cisco Packet Tracer tutorial or course is for absolutely beginners, where with each next tutorial we will be building more complex networks and doing also configurations of devices and of these networks. So let's build the network. And to do this, like I mentioned in previous video, here in the left bottom corner in the first tab you can find devices which you would want to add, and we will be adding or clicking here on this second, which is end devices. And to add the PC, here in this tab to the right you will see all these devices like PCs, laptops, servers, etc. Here click on PC and click somewhere on this workspace, and this PC will be added. And do it one more time by clicking again on PC and clicking somewhere else on workspace where you want to add this PC. Now we need to connect these PCs together, and to do that we need to select connections. If you click on it, here you will see different types of connections which we can use to connect these two PCs together and to connect the same purpose devices. For example, if you are planning to connect two PCs, or if you are planning to connect two switches, in normal scenario you would be using copper crossover cable. But here in Cisco Packet Tracer, if you would be using copper straight through cable, that would also work. But in our scenario, let's do it with copper crossover cable, so you just understand why we are doing it. It is because copper crossover cables are used to connect the same purpose devices, like two PCs or two switches, not like a PC to a switch, but two PCs or the same purpose devices. So click on the PC and here use fast Ethernet 0, and then go to another PC and click on it and also connect it to fast Ethernet 0 port. And now these two PCs are connected. Now that these two devices are connected, you might think that they are already able to communicate with each other. But truth is that they are not, because they are not on the same network and they don't even see each other, because they are connected only with physical cable or physical Ethernet cable, but they are not on the same network. That's why in networking we have networks, and networks also consist of logical connection, which includes IP addresses of devices. For these devices, MAC address is already assigned on their network cards, because network cards or Ethernet adapters are those physical devices which are built into these PCs, which has these RJ45 ports to allow these devices to connect, and they have MAC addresses by default. But devices on network also must have IP addresses and must have subnet masks. If we hover over any of these devices, you will see, like for example for this one, fast Ethernet 0, up there is no set IP address, and we can confirm it by clicking into the device and here go into desktop and here select command prompt and here type in ipconfig. And if we type in ipconfig, you can see that IPv4 address is 00, it's not set, and there is no subnet mask. And exactly the same happens with second device. If we click into it, if we click into desktop, if we click into command prompt, and if we type in ipconfig and we hit enter, you can see that there is also no IP address and there is no mask. And we need to set these up to have these two devices also to be on the same network. By default, in real world scenarios, if these devices would be already connected to some network, then DHCP server, for example a router of your DHCP server, would assign IP addresses and subnet masks and gateway address to devices. But in this scenario, we have two devices, so there is nothing what could assign IP addresses. In further videos, we will create our own DHCP server, where I will be explaining you how DHCP server works, and I will demonstrate you how it assigns IP addresses. And now, next step to make a connection between these two devices, we need to add them onto the same network. And to do it, click on one of the PCs. Let's click on this first one. And here in the top, you will see this desktop. And where it says IP configuration, click on this one. And here you can configure IP for this particular desktop or this particular device. And as you can see, currently it is set to static, as we will be adding a static IP. If we would select a DHCP, this would mean the DHCP server would automatically add addresses. However, in this network scenario, we don't have access to any DHCP. Here in IP address, let's create an address 192.168.1 and let's give it a host .10. And if you will click into subnet mask, a subnet mask will be automatically added to this IP address. So this first device will be with host 10. And now by using IP config command, we can check whether we have assigned this IP address to this device. And to do this, we click again into desktop, or we can close this window down. And here we click into command prompt. And here in command prompt, type in IP config and hit enter. And here you will see that we have assigned this IPv4 address, which in our scenario is 192.168.10, and subnet mask we have 255.255.255.0. So this device is configured now with static IP address. Now we do have to do exactly the same with another device. So let's click on another device, and here in the top navigation again, let's select desktop. And here click into IP configuration, and we will type in IP address 192.168.1.. And for host, we will give this 20. And also click into subnet mask, and subnet mask for this also will be added automatically. And close this window down. And also let's open a command prompt, and here type in IP config and hit enter. And here we can see that this device also we have IPv4 address 192.168.1.20, and subnet mask for this device is also 255, so this means that they are on the same networks. And now to make sure that these two devices are able to communicate, you can use ping command, as ping command is used exactly for this purpose. So let's type in ping. And let's type in the IP address of this first device. As currently, you see, we are pinging from the device 192.168.1.20. Let's ping address which ends with .10. So 192.168.1.10. And hit enter. And as you can see, this connection is working, as currently this device is replying. We can see that 4 requests were sent and 4 requests were replied. This means that we have successfully created a peer-to-peer network with 2 PCs, where we have assigned IP addresses to each of them, and we assigned subnet masks so they are on the same network and they are able to communicate. I hope this video helped you to understand how to build simple network and configure IP addresses in Cisco Packet Tracer. In further videos, we will start building more complex networks. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.